Professor Sapna Nirula's work in the area of use of ICTs, information and communication technologies, for sustainable development
has won her many accolades
nationally and internationally. Through her research and capacity building work, she has also contributed to a number of central government initiatives, including the National Mission for Sustainable Agriculture. And so, Professor Sapna's insights run up to the 8th National Annual Sustainability Conference, India and Sustainability Standards, are extremely valuable. ISS is organized by CRB and will take place virtually from 27 to the 29th of October 2021. Professor Sapna, you are a well-known academician, researcher, practitioner in sustainability, and you have made immense contribution to the field of sustainability in the business landscapes through your teaching, research and consultancy efforts. Ma'am, how important is it to seed sustainability practices at a younger age, especially introducing it in academics? How is your university supporting this?
Thank you, Manjunath, for these kind words. Although, you know, I have done a quantum of work, but I think, you know, as far as sustainable development goals are concerned, this is just the start. And each one of us as a professional, as an academician, have to do our bit. So I still feel that I have got a lot of work to do in this field. Youth are actually the architects of our future. They hold the maximum energy and they have an important role to play in shaping the economy as well as society, especially the challenges that COVID-19 has posed us, mainly, you know, youth are hit by these challenges because of the problems of unemployment across the globe, problems of vaccination and cultural engagement. So although there are challenges, but youth hold lot of energy, and they are I see them as a promise for the future. In fact, if you talk about us, our generation has failed them. The problem that we are facing today, the problems of climate change, the problems of disasters, forest fires, did we see such a huge incidence of forest fires across the globe in the previous years? No. Floods, you see the South Asian region, tsunamis, etc. And you know, all these, and the loss of biodiversity and the aftermaths and the impacts that have happened, it is a result of hundreds of years of economic progress, which was only thinking about economic and, you know, business gains and business models. So in fact, our generation has failed them, but I see them as a promise for the future, where they can adopt new sustainable business models. They can actually change our thinking, whether it is the climate change or our lifestyle, or, you know, and youth have an important role to play in this entire this thing. And universities have a bigger role, where they can train them, they can empower them, they can launch new skill programs. For example, at School of Management Studies, we have MBA in Sustainable Development and Management program, which trains them not only to be a manager, but a sustainability manager. So besides the conventional management education, they also get trained into sustainability functions, whether it is renewable energy management or the blue economy or climate change and development, sustainable business leadership. It's not only through formal education, but also the informal education plays an important role in training the youth. I am talking about a lot of, you know, certificate programs that are coming up in this area of CSR and sustainability. So I see that, you know, they are the future drivers, and universities are the change makers. They train these change makers. So very important role education sector has to play.
So talking about youth, youth empowerment, youth partnership and youth guidance are the main objectives of Youth for Sustainability India Alliance. And CRB is a member of this movement. Is the participation and contribution of the youth sustainable right now? as we have less than 10 years to achieve the sustainability development goals, popularly known as SDGs.
Yes, right now, and even you know before that, we should have been doing this. In fact, see the one the children who are right now in at the school level, you know, after 10 years they will become university students, they will be part of businesses, they will be part of you know, various other multilateral organizations, they will be at their job. And our duty is to train them right now, catching them young at the school level, at the university level, so that, you know, the way they think their future. Because, you know, sustainable development is all about, you know, future generations. And the generation that is at the school and university level, they are going to be at the helm of affairs after 10 years. So I think we have to train now. I see, you know, five, you know, points that are very important here. Number one is new technologies, right? We actually need new technologies, and this I think we have to train our youth through universities, through other informal and formal education systems to invent new technologies that can shape the world. Profits have been at the forefront. Some of the, you know, major business thinkers have also said that the business of business is to do business. But I think now this proposition is changing. And business of business is not to do business. Business of business is to, you know, work for the society, invent products and services which do not only make profits, but also useful for all the strata of society. We need people who are the change makers. You don't need people who are doing the business in the most conventional way. We don't need emulators. We need change makers who are thinking of new things and who are talking about new skills. Then it is very important for all of us to see how community development initiatives are taking place. So we have to involve the communities in the business initiatives as well. So I think CRB also has got a lot of role to play. I know their work in water, textile, and in responsible business practices, especially the work that they are doing in sustainable lifestyles and the work in sustainability standards. They have a very promising role in this entire ecosystem.
And people who are change makers, that's what we need. And as you have been an integral part of India and Sustainability Standards Conference over the years, so how do you see CRB's role in contributing to businesses integrating sustainability in their practice? How do you see your university and CRB partnering in advancing the discourse on sustainability?
CRB is already a, you know, partner for us, because a lot of our students did summer internship with CRB, and you know, by providing these opportunities to our students, CRB has in fact contributed to this particular action. So summer internship is one activity, and then we have a, you know, 6-month major project activity that will be taken up, and I'm sure many of them will be working at CRB. Many of our students are working for this conference as well, which is giving them exposure. Moving on, you know, the researchers at the school are also in touch with the CRB for writing, you know, joint proposals and contributing to research. Then, you know, exchange of speakers from CRB side and from the university side, collaborative research and, you know, partnerships for youth transformation. These are some of the projects that, you know, have a lot of potential. We have already started something with CRB, and I'm sure we have a long way to go, but I am fully confident of CRB's work, you know, and also ISS, the way it has been designed, the various sessions, they have covered each and every aspect of sustainability, not only at the regional scale, but at the international landscape as well. So I think a lot of good work is coming out of CRB, and we are happy to collaborate with them today and in the future as well.
Very thoughtful insights, ma'am, and thanks, Professor Sapna Nirula, for speaking to Smart Sustenance. It's an honor to speak to you, ma'am, and thank you very much, ma'am.
Thank you, Manjunath.
We at Smart Sustenance are conducting a series of interviews with the sustainability experts in the run-up to the Indian Sustainability Standards Conference by CRB, a virtual conference from the 27th to the 29th of October. And this year's theme is Accelerating and Reinforcing Transformative Change for Societal Resilience. And the registration link is given in the description. Thank you very much.